So boyfriend
told 10 bucks between their breath.
All right. We're going to move on now after we've insulted the strippers
of
America.
Take a sip of timing.
Should pigment dictate your punishment? Oh boy, race. Last month, the Departments of Education and Justice sent letters to public schools telling them to discipline students more or less harshly according to their race. The goal to ensure that black and Latino students aren't being punished more than white and Asian students, even if they're more likely to misbehave. This week, two civil rights commissioners condemned the policy, saying it would likely make classrooms more chaotic. Speaking of bad behavior, wow.
I'm worried about that really skinny cat.
Well, you know.
That cat should be suspended.
It's a bulimic cat. All right, why don't I just get this over with and go to Nick?
Can I excuse myself from the table?
No, first what I'm going to do is tell the editors, I'll create a blank spot to cut this section out right now.
I don't have anything inflammatory to say.
All right, okay. How do you feel about this topic that we are discussing now? Okay, go.
Well, the story implies that blacks and Latinos are showing up for class, which I don't believe in the first place.
There you go.
But no, this shows more of the Obama administration. Mm-hmm. I don't want to sound like a far right loon.
Yeah.
No. But this
after that comment.
There's no logic. It's all emotion based.
Right.
This type of ruling.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying?
No.
There's no reasoning involved.
Well,
they're trying to. I mean, this goes against.
Well.
Everything that we've learned as a civil society.
There you go. No, but I think what you're trying to say, let me throw this to Sonny, is that they're expecting less from a group of people, blacks
which
and Latinos,
is racist.
Which is racist. To me, it's saying we don't expect them to adhere to the same rules that whites and Asians do.
Isn't that more
insulting?
It goes to victimization. You know, I want to be funny and make a joke about it and like hurt his feelings real fast, but rather than doing that, I want to be actually serious because it goes to victims.
Yes.
It makes you victims. And if you want to know why black kids drop out of school while they're not at school, it's because they're learning progressive crap, like the color of their skin makes them less than, so they stop going.
Yeah.
And where do you find them? You find them on the street corner where they're hustling and they're making money the capitalistic way.
Yeah.
Now, I wish they would choose a different product, but nonetheless, they're still going after the money. And that is the point. And when you have people that want to constantly put it on that it is the color of your skin, it goes to prove that it doesn't matter whether it's coming from a white person or coming from a black person, it's still ignorance.
Yeah, but where are
that
they
was great.
Where are they learning that they're less than? That's my question.
In the structure of what we're talking about now is in school. When you hear a teacher say, it's not your fault, or your mother, look, my mother's a crackhead, my dad can barely read. Okay, I graduated at 16 in the top 10 of my class. So to me, that is not an excuse that can be used for anything. So when the school tells them they're less than and that they can't be judged to other students.
I thought you were pushing it off on white society in general, saying that they were less than.
Look, I don't care about white people to give a damn about that.
Well, you should.
But seriously,
we care about
I really
you.
Don't.
I love this. This is the greatest.
I think we see a new sitcom coming.
I do. Sonny and Nick.
Sonny and partly Sonny.
I don't even
Sonny
know
and Cloudy.
Yeah.
I don't know.
All right. Jonah, interesting. When you were in school, you actually stabbed the chemistry teacher with a hunting knife.
Yeah.
And you didn't go to detention because you were a pretty girl.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What did I learn from that? Oof. I need to get better at my knifing skills.
Exactly. What do you make of this story?
It's, you know, we're bombarded with the idea of, I think, affirmative action a lot, or at least as I was growing up, that was the big sort of issue being discussed. Now it seems like this is negative reaction when it comes to discipline. I think that discipline should be served out when there's misbehavior, obviously. Mm-hmm. Teachers don't like having to discipline more or less than they need to. Like, it's time out of their day. Mm-hmm. It's more paperwork. So it's
you're
just
avoiding
not
the
beneficial.
Race part of this story, but go ahead.
Of course I am.
No, that's what your generation
I'm
has to grow
some. I'm the white girl on the table.
Yeah, I don't think that was the important part of the story.
No.
Yeah.
It's about education. and discipline.
You are doing the pageant thing.
Yeah,
you
absolutely.
Are doing the pageant thing.
It's my default.
It's a bad what we need is education. Andy?
Yes.
Should Obama be impeached?
Yes. Well, yeah. I mean, I don't know what that has to do with this story, but yes. I don't get this. They say schools violate federal law when they even-handedly implement neutral policies. I want to know what federal law you could possibly violate by even-handedly implementing neutral policies. Also, does this apply to gender, too? If more boys than girls are being punished, which they probably are.
Right.
Does that violate federal law?
No.
What if more straight students are punished than gay students? Does that violate federal law? The Civil Rights Act covers all of this stuff. Mm-hmm. So they got to figure this out. I also don't understand. They, in this letter, they point out that they have found that racial discrimination in schools is a real problem. Mm-hmm. Well, it seems to me if that's the case, then the answer is for schools to do exactly what they're being told they can't do, which is apply everything in an even-handed manner. Isn't that how you get rid of discrimination?
No, it's really simple. Think about who's running the schools. Progressives run the schools. They have their hands in every aspect of the school. If there's racism in the school when it comes to discipline, then it is a damn progressive that is putting it out there, okay? So you do not get to create a problem, then swoop in like Superman to fix it and think that
Amen,
we're going to say blind to it.
Amen. Yeah. Right on the money.
When you said you don't get to do that, did you mean
I mean you at
me?
The moment.
I feel like I am allowed to do that.
Oh, you're so cute.
Right?
But you didn't answer the question. Should Obama be impeached?
I did answer the question. I said yes. I know what show I'm on.
Good.
Not over this issue.
Yeah.
No, it's Holder.
It's Holder.
I should have been gone 2 years ago.
Holder is...
He's stepping down.
Every decision he makes is race-based. Reacting to past what he believes is past.
Exactly.
Repression.
Well,
exactly.
Then I'll just add, Ray Nagin hates black people.
Okay, there you go.
Did you say Ray Nagin?
Yes.
Okay.
Ray Nagin, Democrat.
I'm glad you clarified
Democrat,
that.
Ray Nagin hates black people.
He's in jail now.
Standing in the camera.
All right, we got to take a break. Coming up, wristwatches, device that tells time, or a tool used by Satan to control your mind. Our 15-part series starting tomorrow, I think. Why do BU students want to ban Robin Thicke? I don't know. I just drank two bottles of cough syrup, and I can't feel my face.